Well, it's springtime, which means flowers are finally blooming, but you've also got to watch out for those pesky weeds. Our Pepper Baker spoke with a woman whose entire backyard is under attack by an invasive species called kudzu.
Right over here is where it gets the most out of hand.
Ginger Hudson has overcome a lot of battles. She lost her first husband and survived breast cancer, but now she's at war with kudzu.
10 years ago, we had it under control. I don't even know the name of the stuff that my husband used. He got it from a place that is no longer in business.
It's actually quite pretty to look at, which is why landscaper Greg Israel, who owns U.S. Lawns in Macon, says made it useful.
Kudzu was introduced intentionally to America, imported from Japan in the 1930s. It was considered a ground cover, and it was used for erosion control.
But don't let looks fool you. Kudzu is an invasive species that attacks everything in its path.
It's just choking everything out. It's covering them. You can't see anything. Like there was a tree underneath that big bush right there, but it's no longer there because the kudzu is killing it.
It grows more rapid than anything else that can compete with it, and it just chokes it out.
Now, Israel says it grows rapidly because it spreads through its seeds and its roots. You can see its growth pattern right here with this vine extending outward with plans to cover more ground.
It just invades everywhere it's at. It hasn't been planted all over the southeast, but through birds, through wind, it's moved across the southeast United States at a rapid pace.
Israel says kudzu covers about 7 million acres across the southeast since it thrives in a hot and humid climate. But how do you get rid of it?
The best defense is consistency. If you've got a stand and you're mowing it, you need to mow it consistently. So it'll eventually, if it can't get sunlight, if it can't get nutrients, it'll eventually will die. But we're talking months and years of being consistent.
Israel says it takes about 40 to 80 gallons of chemical treatments per acre to control it, which can get pricey since it grows about a foot a day.
The chemicals aren't the solution. The chemicals are an assist. Therefore, when you go with kudzu, trying to attack it with a chemical is not practical.
Israel advises against pulling it by the roots, which Hudson can't anyway since she's allergic to it, but she's just looking for anyone to help.
You got way too many to just pull up by the roots. I don't want to set fire to it. They say that doesn't work either. Don't want to use Roundup because you don't want to kill everything that's around it. So I just need to know what to use.
In Jones County, Pepper Baker, 13 WMAZ News.
Israel says some reports suggested using goats to graze on kudzu, but the best way to find it is keeping a well-maintained yard.